Welcome to FirstFleet tenFour. Hello and welcome to the FirstFleet tenFour podcast. My name is Elizabeth Windham and I'll be your host today. And I am joined by one of our driver trainers and one of our regional safety managers. So welcome to the podcast, you guys.
Thank you.
Thank you, Liz.
All right. So if you could go ahead and introduce yourselves to everybody, we'll let them know.
My name is James Mcintosh. I am a driver trainer out of Oxford, PA.
Oxford, PA.
And I'm Roger Poulin, Regional Safety Manager out of the Northeast.
And I must admit to everyone that I've noticed we've had a lot of very Southern voices on the podcast. So I'm making a very concerted effort to get some Yankees on here. So
nice.
Well, thank you for the...
Welcome to the podcast.
Yankee classification. Yeah,
yeah. Hey, what? Glad you guys are here. This is awesome.
Thank you.
So, hey, I know that both of you are pretty into wellness and you're pretty fit dudes. And I know Roger was always carrying that bicycle with him.
Yes,
and
I do.
Going on bike rides. And what I've never actually learned what you do in the wintertime. Actually,
wintertime, I do a lot of hiking and do some snowshoeing too.
Snowshoeing.
When I find time. And I do some indoor cycling too. And also when I'm traveling, if I don't have the bicycle with me, I'll hit the gym and hit the treadmill.
Okay, gotcha. Nice. Snowshoeing. That sounds very cold.
It's a good workout. It's a good time.
Yeah, I actually made a joke at my expense on one of the previous podcasts about winter driving for Southerners. I know. Go ahead and laugh. I know. And I literally said to all the Maine guys, I apologized to all of you because anything more than 3 inches of snow is officially a blizzard in my world. So,
wow.
I know. It's silly, but it's just, I mean, goodness sakes, I'm from South Carolina, you know? I mean, it's a national emergency.
And you all don't get much snow down there.
We do not. It is a shock to the system for sure.
I bet.
Yeah, I moved to Tennessee and I had to buy closed-toed shoes. So that first winter, it was the coldest thing ever.
Wow.
Oh, man. So I'm learning how to dress for Tennessee, but this is the farthest north I've ever lived.
Wow.
And yeah, I must have, one day I might visit you.
You should come visit me sometime.
Need to come live up here.
I don't know about that.
Come on.
How about a week? I'll give you a week.
All right, we'll take it.
Okay. But no, okay, so wellness. So you got winter, you got your summer wellness, you got when you're traveling. What would you say are some things that we can all do to be better about wellness? Because we're stuck in a truck all day. You know, we can't get around, we can't move. What do you recommend?
I would recommend developing a routine when you're not driving, when you get out of your truck, do some stretching, walk around the truck, park further away from the truck stop so you get to walk to the truck stop.
Yeah.
And build a routine.
Okay. A routine of
either
like an exercise routine?
Exercise routine.
Okay.
Or parking away and, you know, do some lunges, some squats each day.
Yep. Okay. All right. That's cool. Yeah. I go on a lunchtime walk and there's one side of the building that has no windows. And that's the side I'll do lunges.
Right. You know, right. And
it's only so much public embarrassment you can take, you know. So a routine. So like every time you get out of the truck or like when you go and open the doors to go into the dock, do you like do lunges down the truck lane?
No, I might stretch a little bit.
You might stretch a little. Okay. Yeah,
it depends how far along I've been driving.
Okay.
But then again, I haven't driven for a long time.
True.
But I'm driving a different vehicle.
Yeah.
And when I get out to fuel up there too, I'll bend over, touch my toes and stretch a little bit, do my calves.
Okay. What about you, James? Do you have any recommendations?
Yeah, so in addition to what Roger said, you know, because I now unload trailers, I don't go to the gym as often, but mine revolves more around eating. And I think
mistake. Abs are made in the kitchen, not the gym.
There you go. So I think a mistake that a lot of drivers make is they eat out a lot.
Okay.
That costs you a lot of money, but it's also horrible for your health.
Sure.
I was over the road for 5.5 years, and when I came off the road, I lost 20 pounds right away.
Whoa.
And that was based on eating habits.
Yeah.
People should pack lunches.
Okay.
You know, pack a healthy lunch, something that's going to fill you up, something that's healthy, but don't stay away from these truck stop eateries where there's a lot of fatty foods and unhealthy things. Because a lot of times you're tired, it's the end of the day, you're going to eat that meal and you're going to go to bed. Well, that food is sitting in your gut and it's not digesting properly because there's no way of burning it off. So I really suggest drivers do that.
Okay,
you know, it costs you less money. It takes a little bit of time, but you're also you're not spending that money on things that are going to make you unhealthy.
Right.
A lot of drivers.
You're saving money and health.
Right. Yeah. And a lot of drivers will have weight issues, but also heart issues
because of
poor eating habits. So.
Gotcha. Okay.
That's what I would say.
Yeah. I know Mark and I talk about wellness a lot. That's our favorite podcast topic, actually. Mm-hmm. So we talk about all the other stuff, but Mark McKnight and I love to get on and talk about wellness because that's something we both care about. And mm-hmm. So I love hearing more people's recommendations about wellness. Mm-hmm. And so we've covered physical wellness and working out. We've covered eating wellness, mm-hmm. dietary wellness, I guess. But there's also financial wellness as
Absolutely.
Well. Do you have any tips for our drivers about how to, because cooking for yourself does save money, so that is, I guess, a financial wellness tip. But again, if you're buying fancy food, that could cost more. I don't know. What do you recommend?
Set a percentage of your income aside for saving.
How much?
I wouldn't do a lot. I probably less than 10%. Like,
okay.
For me, I don't, Dave Ramsey might say something different. And I do love his books, by the way.
Okay.
But the majority of my check goes in the bank. And then
sure.
I'll pull, a couple $100 a month for myself. Not
yeah.
much, just enough that I could buy something if I wanted to, and it helps you with saving as well. But, I just think that, we have... all that money that goes in the pot is not all towards bills, but what I'm paying myself is not a lot, is what I'm saying.
Gotcha.
So savings is a bill as well. You have to treat savings like it's a bill.
Ah.
So that's one. Savings is that is one of my bills, but the money
that's genius.
Right. So
I'm gonna use that.
Yeah. You have to treat savings like a bill. So
yeah.
when I say I pull $200 away, that's just for me to do whatever I want with.
Gotcha. That's nothing to do with savings.
Nothing to do with savings. So you want another percentage of your bills, which is saving. One of your bills is savings. It has to go towards.
You know what's cool? Actually, I've really enjoyed when we switched over to Workday, I went in and updated my direct deposit, and I actually now have two bank accounts. And because I wasn't doing a good job on saving. And so I actually set up one bank account just for a savings account. And so I have 90% of my check goes into my checking account to pay bills and take care of stuff. But then I have another 10% that goes into my savings account. And mm-hmm. then I never even see the money. Because I'll be honest, I get tempted. If it's mm-hmm. there, I'm like, oh, look at that. I didn't know I had that much money in my account,
Exactly.
It's like...
And they say don't
put
all your money in one place. I have several banks.
Sure.
I have several banks.
Oh, okay.
And
yeah.
there's not like a lot in each one, but it's enough. It's, it's for me psychologically, if I don't have to look at it, it's not there.
Right. Absolutely. And I know that right now I think we can have up to four direct deposits. I think we can have four direct deposit options. Like we can break up our money and our paycheck into four different accounts. So I'm like, why wouldn't we use it,
Right. Yeah. And another great option is the 401k option, that FirstFleet option.
Very true.
Offers with a match.
Absolutely.
And then once you're in 401k, you're not tempted to take the money out.
Right. A match is free money. So why would you pass up free money?
And I was called to a financial consultant to see what they recommend to put away to depending on your needs and your costs.
Absolutely.
And your lifestyle.
Anything else? What do you think? Your savings is a bill. Savings is a bill.
Savings is a bill.
Savings,
you have to treat it as such.
Okay.
Yes.
We're going to set up direct deposits, especially for savings. We're going to work on...
contributing to your 401k on a regular basis.
Yes, absolutely. Monthly.
And sleep.
Sleep.
Sleep's
Ooh,
important.
Absolutely.
I heard, don't quote me on this, but I heard that when you're sleeping, if you get at least 8 hours, there's like a chemical that goes to your brain that flushes out all the junk.
You're the second person today who's told me that.
And when you don't get enough sleep,
that
all that junk's not allowed to get out of your brain.
Yeah.
So that's why you get all the fatigue and the illness and things like that. So
sure.
Sleep is very important.
And
they say at least 8 hours sleep, which is hard for drivers to do. I know, like for me it is, but.
Sure. And fatigue is a killer on the road.
Absolutely.
So I know I've made some dumb mistakes driving late at night, and fatigue is very dangerous.
Mm-hmm. So you got to recognize when you are fatigued, when you are tired, when you need to pull off the side of the road and get that rest.
Absolutely.
And as James said, you need to get at least 8 hours a night.
Sure.
You know, to stay healthy.
Yes. Oh,
and
yeah,
let your body
for sure.
recover.
Yeah, because, I mean, you'll gain, even if you're eating the best diet, working out, you'll still gain weight if you're not sleeping.
Absolutely.
I mean, I've seen that in my own life. So, you know, when I was pulling 4 hours a night, I mean, I just couldn't help it. It's just how your body works. So,
and they were saying that there's some research that's coming out that's linking Alzheimer's and dementia to people who don't get enough sleep because all the garbage isn't being flushed out of their brains. So
that
it's causing their
sense.
Brains to have issues.
Yeah. Essentially plaque in your brain,
mm-hmm.
the whatever you call it. Yeah. It's like you got to brush your teeth every day.
You have to brush your teeth. You have
healthy.
To bathe.
Yeah.
You have to let your brain heal. You have to let your brain
got to clean your brain, and you do that by your 8 hours of rest.
Exactly.
Nice. Okay. Love it. This is awesome. Tell me this. How long have you been with First Fleet? I don't even know if we talked about this.
2 years.
I've been with First Fleet since 2013. A driver for 5 years, and the last 3 years I've been a regional safety manager.
Nice. Okay. Very cool. And what is the thing you love most about First Fleet?
I like that you can make really good money as long as you work hard. And I know it sounds weird. It's like, well, duh. But like, you know, there are not a lot of companies out there that can promise that. So I've noticed with First Fleet, you know, if you work hard, the money will come.
Sure.
It'll come. And one of the things I do as a trainer, and this, my trainer did the same thing with me. I showed him him or her. I've only had two trainees because I just started training. But I showed both of my trainees when they first started how much I made the previous year.
Yeah.
So that they know, like, wow, I can do this. And this was, you know,
yeah.
and I didn't really count the training part of it. I said, you know, take X amount of dollars off because of training, but this is what you can
sure.
you can actually make. And their eyes are big, like, yeah, you know, you can do this.
Yeah.
But you have to work hard. You have to put the work out there. And things aren't always going to be perfect. You know, you're not going to work in perfect conditions all the time. But
oh, goodness, you're in Pennsylvania. It's going to snow.
Right. But as long as you work hard, you can make really good money, especially here at First Fleet. So.
Cool.
What I enjoy about working at First Fleet is it's family atmosphere. People treat each other with respect and dignity on a regular basis. Doesn't matter who, if you're the president, all the way down to an admin.
Yeah.
You know, and the driver is the most valued commodity we have.
Absolutely.
Without the drivers, we're not a company.
Yeah. Oh, 100%.
So in my part of my job, I enjoy the fact that I get to meet people and help people learn new skills they may not have or develop skills they might be weak on.
Sure. You
know, if I can see somebody improve, it makes me feel good.
That's awesome. Yeah. I love hanging out with the safety guys and the trainers as I'm learning from this conference that you guys are just a wealth of information and I'm learning so much. I'm learning about trucks. It's funny. I know how to do a great pre-trip. Can't drive one, but I can do a pre-trip.
That's good.
Yeah. Well, after making all those videos with Ron Crow, it kind of stuck in there.
Good stuff.
Well, awesome. Well, thank you both for your time. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
We appreciate you.
Thank
you.
Hey, absolutely.
Thanks for all that you do.
I'm glad to be here. So hope you all have a great rest of your day. And as always, drive safe.